Hey guys, Jason from Train 2.0 here, and in this video, we're going to go over Patrick Kane's goal scoring formula, where we're going to look at the patterns that helped him win the Art Ross Trophy in the 2015-2016 season. So this is essentially a case study where we're going to look at goals like this, and that's something we call hiding the shot in the release, something that I call critical event identification, which is when he does this kind of thing. And we all know how this ends. And then we're also going to get into being in the right spot at the right time, at the right speed. And this is something, this is two factors where Kane gets into blind spots and then has the right timing. So you might wonder, why a formula? Well, because I look at skills as something like a multiplication table, whereas I look at a formula as like solving a problem. And there's a lot of people who have really great skills, and Patrick Kane is certainly one of those people. He's possibly the absolute best in the NHL, but that's not the reason that he's scoring so many goals. The reason he's scoring goals is because he has a formula, he has a pattern, and the question that I'm asking in this video is, from his patterns, can we learn how to do what he does so that we can learn and get better? Now, the Train 2.0 formula is to try to explain 80% of the effect. I'm not going to try and explain the 15% of the goals that happened from kind of random things that can occur during a season. What I'm trying to do is create a formula which is clear and specific, it's visual, and it's actionable so that you can use it right away. And the whole purpose is to instruct, not to prove that this is the only formula and that Patrick Kane goes to bed at night after his time at the chalkboard creating his formula. This is designed to instruct. So before we get into this, we got to talk about something that I call upstream effects. And what happens in hockey a lot is we see point B. We see it, okay? So we see the nice goal. We see the nice dangle at the end. And so we practice point B. We practice everything that's happening here. But things actually happen at point A, down the stream or up the stream. So you actually add some ingredients in up the stream, and then you see them down the stream. So if you actually change things at point A, then that actually changes things at point B. So what we look at is four upstream ingredients that Kane has. And like I said, there's kind of an other category where there's some random things, shootout goals, net front goals. But then we looked at things like the right timing, his rhythmic release, critical event anticipation, and finding the right space, so getting in the blind spot. And I'm going to show you what these are quickly, and then I'm going to give you an opportunity to learn these more in depth later on. So the first one that we're going to get into is the rhythmic release. So how Kane often hides his release in his shot. Now, this is a skill, but it's also a tactic because he needs to have the correct patterning and the timing and spacing. And so what you see, we see this all the time, is that Kane is actually kind of shifting from side to side as he's stick handling. So as he's stick handling, he's shifting his body and then he's able to hide his release in the shot. In this one here, again, we see this all the time from Kane, where he ends up picking it up. And kind of what you saw here, exactly right here, this is how he simply stick handles. Is that, as you can see, he's kind of stepping and stick handling at the same time. And then that's what ends up happening here as well. As he goes in, he's stepping and stick handling. And because of that rhythm, the goalie actually has a hard time picking it up and reading the release. And again, here we have Kane doing the exact same thing where he's, and he's very well known for this, is hiding his release in the shot. So he's stick handling and stepping at the same time, and the goalie has a hard time reading exactly when that puck is going to come off his blade. So we call that the rhythmic release, and that accounts for about, or that accounted for 15 of his goals where he executed that skill. or that tactic. The next thing that Kane is really well known for is what something I call critical event anticipation. Now, this didn't contribute a ton to all of his goals. I counted it as 7 of his 46 goals had critical event anticipation, but he has a knack for this. He has a knack for understanding when defensemen are under pressure in a way that's going to not expose him defensively. So in this situation, he actually maintains defensive side. He actually stays in a good defensive position and then was quick enough to anticipate back here what was going to happen. So what he ended up figuring out was right here, he could already see what was about to happen. So he planned it way before that puck even got to him and way before that turnover happened. And so what he did was he was able to get a stick and then he gets on a breakaway and is able to score. And he does this time and time again, where he's coming up with these critical event anticipations. So right there, he's able to effortlessly come back into the zone and he's reading this as that this guy is under pressure. He's staying in a defensive side position and he's jumping on it. And he has an absolute knack for this. And this is one of my favorites here because he combines several things. The blind spot, which we talked about, which we're going to talk about in a second. And then he also detects a critical event right here. Boom. And then he is able to get that. So he's able to figure out when players are under distress and he times it just right when that player is in a maximal moment of distress. The other thing that Kane does is he arrives in the right space at the right time. And a lot of coaches will say this, but it's hard to define it. And remember that the Train 2.0's formula aims to be actionable and clear and specific so that people can learn from it. So my definition to help people understand of it is first getting in the right spot is finding the blind spot. And what the blind spot is, you know, if we're actually looking at this defenseman, right behind him is the blind spot. And this was when I was playing or practicing with the Sedins, I'm not sure which one it was, but would consistently find my blind spot as a defenseman. So what they would do was they would actually hang out in this area on purpose to cause me to either turn my head or lose track of them. So what Kane does instinctively is he instinctively finds this defenseman's blind spot. And that you can see that that defenseman is shoulder checking to try and find him. And then watch right here as Kane goes from here, he instinctively finds this defenseman's blind spot. He could hang out here. He could try and chase this puck here, but he instinctively goes into the blind spot area. And then because of that, he's able to score. And I'm going to show you how he does this instinctively again and again. Here's another good one here. We literally see he's going to sneak into this defender's blind spot, sneaks into this guy's blind spot, boom, and then off he goes to the races. Really good, again, event anticipation. And then here is another example where Kane, you're going to see in a blink of an eye, is going to instinctively get into the blind spot. We're going to see right here, and this happens in a blink of an eye. He instinctively gets into the blind spot. Boom. And there's the goal. And I'll show you that at full speed so you can just appreciate just how quickly he gets into that blind spot. Boom. In half a second, he's in the blind spot. He's receiving the puck. So that's kind of one of Kane's tactics for getting in the blind spot. Now, the other part of it is, of course, the timing part of it. It's great if you're in the correct spot, but you need to arrive there at the right time. And so what a lot of players do is they try to play fast, which is of course good. But the problem is that their acceleration is always at the wrong times. So they might be in an open space already and they might accelerate to run themselves out of space. So for example, if Kane didn't have good timing, he might already be here at the blue line and then trying to accelerate, but then he has to stop to pick up the puck. But what Kane does is he's actually not in open space right now. Like if you were to say, are you open right now? He'd say no, but he's accelerating into open space. So this is the open space here, and you're going to see in a second that he accelerates right into it. So, of course, he's a very fast skater. The other thing is that he's also got this fantastic anticipation. And in this clip, you're going to see right here how he accelerates into open space. So right now, he gets the puck, he gets a check, and then he's going to dish it up. But watch what he does as soon as he does that. He accelerates into open space. Look how fast and hard he's going. He just has this instinct that he needs to accelerate into that open space. Then, again, like we mentioned, he makes that pass and immediately finds this player's blind spot. Immediately finds it, gets it back, and is able to rip the shot on net. So this was a very quick breakdown of Kane's four upstream ingredients that he uses. Right timing, which is accelerating into open space, not past it. Rhythmic release, so how he's hiding his shot in his stick handle and stepping. Finding the right space with the blind spot, and then critical event identification. So these four key ingredients actually identify 85% of Kane's goals from his 2015-2016 Art Ross season. So I did better than my goal of 80-20. And I'm hoping that this is helpful for you. So now if it's time to upgrade your upstream actions, think of learning the skill of hiding your shot release in your stick handle. And the key to that, and I refer to this in other videos with Erik Karlsson and other Swedish defensemen on how to find rhythm in your game. Getting into the right space, which is often in a defender's blind spot, timing the acceleration so that you're accelerating into open space, not past it. Remember that, we know Gretzky's quote, which is that you go to where the puck is going, not where it's already been. So if you're in open space already, you probably shouldn't be accelerating faster because you only have the blink of an eye, half a second to get into that open ice. So essentially what you want to be doing is accelerating into open space. And then, of course, critical event anticipation, so being able to anticipate when another player is under duress and then timing and accelerating at the correct time to create that turnover. So that was a very quick breakdown of Patrick Kane's goal scoring formula. You can, if you want more in-depth training, you can actually click right here to get more free training where I have more in-depth breakdowns, and you can also register for free training live. And this is an opportunity to upgrade your formula. And if you like this video, please make sure to comment and let me know. And if you have any questions or requests for future formulas and breakdowns, please leave those in the comment section, and I'm more than happy to get to those. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. I have the button in the bottom right corner. Now, like I said, now is an opportunity if you are a player or a parent or a coach to learn how to upgrade your formula. I have a bunch of free tools that you can get right now. All you have to do is click through to the other page. You just fill out your email and you're taken to a portal where you can get more in-depth details and register for a free live training with me and with Train 2.0. So thanks again for watching, and I release new videos every week, so stay tuned and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.